Hi and welcome to the World Cup on Standby from the South China Morning Post, where we've got three more people who are not going to Russia. Nick Atkin, Paul Riding, and myself, Jonathan White. So, Ivory Coast, China, Italy, and not going to the World Cup.
That's right, Jonathan.
Okay. Is there anyone you're looking forward to watching it with?
No, I'm going to watch it all on my own.
All right, well, we're not going, like we said. Who else isn't going?
Leroy Sané, number one miss.
He could probably feel most sad.
I think he would captain England.
This is the sad thing about these players that aren't going. Most of them would be starting 11 for England.
And other countries. Yeah. So the World Cup will miss them.
Yeah, the real loss to the championship.
Rabiot, who refused to go on standby.
I'd say the handsomest man not going.
Okay, well, that's made me feel bad, but I'll take it.
Printed one of him out in colour.
Yeah?
Because he looks so good.
We keep this on the desk.
Well, that's going on the wall. Yeah. Okay, Paul, you were saying something about you've been in touch with the embassies.
So we tried to reach out to each of the 32 countries that are there, thinking we'd get a flavour for how they celebrate the World Cup. You know, they can't be there either. The very few that bothered to get back to us. Australia felt it prudent to remind us that Australians do actually know their way around a pint. So they told us, no, we won't be organising anything special.
Many others did not get back to us. One that did was the Spanish consulate.
A hopeful statement at the end of the email. We should point out they said, no, we won't be having any parties, but maybe we should, because it seems that Spain are one of the favourites.
So
the
maybe
tone.
Watch this space with Spain.
Maybe. And of course, the saltiest of all of our responses, one of our colleagues wrote off to the Colombian.
They've since been sacked.
Yep. Consulate, summarily
we will
dismissed.
Not name and shame this young man, but
he spelled the country with a U and simply responded with a helpful note on how to spell the country correctly.
It was nice of them to do that.
Yeah. Yeah, they could have ignored the email like a lot of the other consulates.
What's the weirdest thing you've seen?
We did get wind of one particular party. Porn star, former band,
AKB,
former pop singer.
48, Akihabara, 48.
Ewan Makami. She'll be hosting
Idol Group.
World Cup final viewing party in Macau.
I'll be there. I'm sure you will as well, Johnny.
I certainly won't.
The people in Macau are tremendously excited about this, so it's only right that we go and check it out.
So this year, if you're watching the World Cup from a distance, you might want a team to back. Our cult heroes, for example, the heaviest player, Roman Torres.
Yeah.
Who else should people be looking out for if they just want to enjoy the World Cup and not watch England, say, where they'll just be in line for a lot of disappointment?
I don't know. I wasn't expecting that one. You're talking about the next lad.
Move your slide, show on.
Oh, sorry. Pie chart.
Pie chart.
Heaviest lad. We should move on.
How heavy is he?
99 kilograms.
The sticker says 88. Have you got it wrong, or have they?
They got a lot wrong.
Yeah, Panini got a lot wrong. We should base our World Cup on Panini.
I trust FIFA and Panini more than you. Can't even do a proper pie chart.
That's a proper pie chart. He's 100% the heaviest person there.
There's no variable, it's only one thing.
Yeah, heaviest, and he's 100% the heaviest.
He's eating the pie.
By 1 kilo. Moving on.
How short is Shaqiri, do we know?
5'4".
That can't be true.
Okay, so...
Okay,
another bombshell, it just can't be true.
So he's shorter than me, ooh.
Yeah, and at the World Cup.
Yeah.
Japan, lightweight team, probably going to go out.
How light is he? Do we know?
Something like 59 kilos.
Kilos.
Jeez.
Jesse Lingard, 60 kilos.
Right. And the
second
lightest. Tallest player?
Is Dejan Lovren's friend.
Lovren Kalinic.
And if you don't hate the Australians too much, then you could support the youngest player.
Yeah.
18-year-old.
Peculiar thing. I'm going to be following Australia because they have the youngest player of the tournament. Okay, you weirdo. Get out my bar.
All right. Best part about a World Cup?
Collecting the stickers, I think. No, not it.
Funnily
enough. Bit weird.
Yeah.
It's probably World Cup songs.
Ah.
Okay.
Ah, we're going there.
This year, there's bad news. There's only bad songs. One life, one dream, one moment, one team. You lights high, thousand roadblocks, one shot, one truth, no fears, one flag. So that is Will
now
Smith.
We talk about this.
I did not know this was a song.
Will Smith is a bizarre choice.
I didn't know he was still making music.
Anyway, right, is this any better? Deli, 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 yali. Forget that silly handshake and concentrate on goals we marry. No, in short. Is this the worst thing about the World Cup ever?
This is horrifying.
Yeah.
That's the... Now...
there he is. Razor
Ruddock. The most horrendous thing about that is when he humps Gareth Southgate's leg.
So who are Bell and Sperling?
Hopefully we'll never know.
No.
They have previous...
They did. They did a song about Sven, you might remember.
Yeah.
8 years ago,
was
that?
I actually quite like that one and still hum it sometimes to myself in the shower.
Okay.
Yeah. And they went back to the well.
Sven.
Right, we should find out someone else who's got a World Cup song out. Bit of a dark horse, this one. It's also by Sergio Ramos.
I don't speak Spanish, so I don't know what he's singing about. Maybe the lyrics are just poetic.
As I believe, they are perhaps one of the favourites.
He's got quite the singing voice.
Yeah, it's mostly auto-tune, but he does have quite the singing voice. Not his first time on a song. So, we've got a World Cup to be enjoying from some distance. Mm. Probably time we packed up.
Yeah.
All right.
Probably keep this one.